There are two basic type of investing when it comes to capital markets, and that is active investing and there is a passive investing. Typically, we are asked what is the difference between the two. You know, when we look at active investing is when you hire a fund manager to invest on your behalf, and the fund manager then aspires to give you returns over the market. So the market is what we call the benchmark. There are various indices in the market. So typically a Sensex is a benchmark, or say the Nifty 50 is a benchmark. So a fund which benchmarks itself to those funds, when you hire a fund manager, the fund manager typically charges you a fee and aspires to give you returns which are higher than that benchmark. Otherwise, logically, why would you pay anybody money if you know you get returns below that benchmark? So that is called active management. In that active management, when you look at that return above the benchmark, which we call alpha, when you look at that pursuit of that alpha or that return over the benchmark, over the period of time, please understand there is also a risk of underperforming that benchmark. While you aspire with all good intent to form a portfolio of stocks which will aspire to give you returns above the benchmark, there is also a possibility that some of the calls, or for whatever reason, different market conditions, there is a possibility that there is an underperformance to that benchmark. Now, people who invest on the active side understand that there are both these risks. Now, when you look at the other side, and there is a person who will say, no, I do not want to take this underperformance risk. I will buy the market itself, which is the benchmark. Say the Sensex, the 30 stocks in the Sensex, or the 50 stocks in Nifty 50. I will just buy the market and I will get market returns. That is somebody who does passive investing, and that is what we will spend in the next 2 days exploring the world of passive investing, the merits of passive investing, why should you look at passive investing, and whether it is the right investment vehicle or not. Now, that is one reason why you should look at passive investing if you do not want to take the underperformance risk of the market. The other reason that one can look at is probably, you know, when you're starting off. And the best way to start off is to understand the market. And the right way to understand is the market is to buy the market first. First, understand the market, buy the market, say buy the Nifty 50, top 50 stocks of the market, understand how it plays out, understand the risks associated with that market, and then graduate to taking active calls or graduate to taking active fund management calls. That is could be the other way of looking at this, looking at investment. These are things which we will look at in the next 2 days. And I hope at the end of the 2 days, we come up with some meaningful suggestions from our end between Paytm and us. Now, to look at this passive investing going forward, people might say that, okay, you're buying the market. What is so great about it? Let me tell you, when you look, I'll just give you one example, and the example of, say, the Nifty 50, which is the top 50 market capitalized stocks in the market. And you look at those returns over a period of time, the 15-year return of a Nifty 50 is around 12.3. This is the total return index return. And the last 10-year returns has been 11.9. The 7-year returns has been 14.2. And when you look at the composition of, say, the Nifty 50, it comprises of the top 50 traded stocks in the market, or the top 50 market capitalized stocks in the market. Sectorally, it is diversified. Say, the Nifty 50 would look at 13 sectors in itself. And since it is a very dynamic, rule-based sort of mechanism, that 50 stocks over a period of time also change. If you can track it down, you will know that though it is called passive, the underlying 50 stocks are pretty active over a period of 15, 20 years. The stocks which would be there, say 10 years ago, would have changed based on the market capitalization. So when you look at the underlying market, the market is dynamic, and the index itself captures this dynamism in this journey that it undertakes.